Hi folks, so for today's video I thought I might try something a little bit different and run through some of the commands that you can use on the command line to manage Flatpak applications. Now Flatpak applications are applications that are designed to run across a variety of distributions, and I've been trying them out over the past couple of months and I must say I am really quite impressed with just how well they work across so many distributions. Now as you can see here, I have a slightly different operating system set up. I'm giving Pop! OS another go. I was quite impressed with it last time around, and I thought it might be worth another review. So, rather than focus on the software from the native repositories, I'm going to be focusing specifically on Flatpaks. I'm going to be trying to get most of my workflow running through Flatpak applications, just to see how far I can use them. So today I'm just going to be running through some of the basic command line applications. But before I do that, it's probably worth me recommending the Getting Started guide on the official Flatpak website. Now, I'm quite surprised with the number of distributions that actually ship with Flatpak support out of the box, but not every distribution does. So to check to see the status of your distribution, I will just put a link to the official Getting Started documentation in the description below. And if your distribution is not listed amongst them in the Getting Started guide, it is almost certain that your distribution will have its own documentation for Flatpaks. So also one thing to bear in mind with Flatpaks is that I'm going to be focusing mostly on the FlatHub application center. And the reason for that is because there are just a huge wealth of applications there, and it's a good place to get started, but there are other Flatpak repositories available. So to start off with the most basic command, you can try Flatpak. Notice the spelling there, Flatpak list. And this lists my currently installed Flatpak applications. And as you can see, I've got a pretty decent selection already installed. I've got Discord, I've got OBS Studio, I've got Skype, which is particularly important for meetings with people who aren't necessarily as interested in Linux as we are, of course. We've got the Audacity, there's Kdenlive. Kdenlive has quite a really good Flatpak package there. Stunt Rally, really good game. And then a few other sort of dependencies that get installed alongside some of the Flatpak applications. So to have a search to see if a particular application is available in your currently set up list of Flatpak repositories, it's very simple. Just do Flatpak search. And for example, for today's tutorial, I'm just going to be using Qtox as the as an application to demonstrate with. But you can use just about any other application you find in the FlatHub store. So I'm going to look for Qtox. Oh, and as we can see here, we can see that Qtox is available. It's stable, and it is in the FlatHub repository there with a little bit of a description. So to install it, it is quite straightforward. So you do flatpak, and also notice that I'm not using the sudo command prior to it. We can do flatpak install. Now here's the bit where it slightly differs from your traditional package managers like apt or pacman, where you have to put in the name of the repository first, and then usually it's just best to copy and paste. That's what I like to do there. And then this goes. So then it asks you for some permissions and gives you a bit of basic information there. Just press Y if you are happy with that. And it basically downloads and installs Flatpaks immediately for you right there, rather quick. And if I just wanted to see if Qtox was readily available right out of the box, and there we go. So Qtox is immediately there, up and running. So that is pretty cool. And yeah, it's as simple as that. So let's get rid of Qtox actually for the moment, right? And then we can do Flatpak list. So there we can see all of our current Flatpak lists. And I am looking for Qtox. Where is it there? There we go. It's this one here. So how do we go about removing it? Well, it is actually rather quite straightforward. So we can do, it's a very similar command. Flatpak remove, and then the list of the and the sort of the name of the Flatpak application. Now, the name of the Flatpak application is a little bit more than just Qtox. It does come with a little bit of extra information there. But yeah, Flatpak remove io github Qtox, and then press enter. Uninstalling from system. Is this okay? Yes. Uninstalling, and we're done. So there we go. We just searched for, found, installed, and then removed a Flatpak package. It was as easy as that. And one other command that I'm going to leave you with today, which is particularly useful, is Flatpak remove --unused. And it just has told me that there are no unused applications. So when a Flatpak application is installed, sometimes it will need one or two other Flatpak Flatpak dependencies to make the application work as desired. However, if you happen to remove that, it doesn't automatically remove all of its dependencies. So from time to time, you then go to it's worth using the command Flatpak remove unused just to make sure that you don't have any unused dependencies lying around. You can also do Flatpak update. And Flatpak update just basically looks through all of your Flatpak applications to see if there are any that you can update. All of my Flatpak applications are currently updated, so I don't have to worry about that. And those are the basic applications of the Flatpak command line tools. And yeah, I find it pretty straightforward. It's not massively dissimilar to what you're used to with apt or pacman or dnf. Yeah, I must say, I am incredibly impressed with Flatpaks, and it's looking like I can actually get the overwhelming majority of my workflow available as Flatpaks, which means that I can switch out my Linux distribution for anything that's supported by Flatpaks, and I can get my near exact similar workflow, with of course the obvious exception of the desktop environment and the specific quirks of the operating system itself. But yeah, it's definitely worth a go. I can highly recommend it. So if you're looking to get started with Flatpaks, I will of course put a link to the official getting started guide down in the description below. Thank you very much for watching. That's about it from me today, and I think you can expect a Pop OS review in the future. Also, what I'll do, I'll just make sure that there are a couple of playlists for other similar videos to this, which are being listed as part of the end screen. So if you feel inclined, please feel free to check out some similar videos to this in afterwards. So thank you very much for watching. That's about it from me today. And until next time, I've been Chris Ware, and you've been awesome. Take care now.